Hey, I am Jelle, and I made a lot of games for myself this year. But in the spirit of the holidays, I thought, why don't I make a game for you that we can all play together to celebrate this little community we built this year. You probably know this, but making a multiplayer game is a lot of work. Way more than a simple single player one. There are way more moving pieces that all need to work together to make the game work. Getting the info from different clients and trying to predict what they will do is quite a challenge. So I thought about an easier way to solve this problem. Why don't I look for a service that already has servers and a way to interact with each other? I could use something like Twitch. You've probably heard of the legendary tale of Twitch Plays Pokemon, a Twitch livestream event where everyone controlled the same character and together they had to complete the game. Everyone was just spamming commands in the chat, hoping red would do as they say. And we all know how that went. I wanted to do something more personal, but still keep it online so anyone from all over the world, on whatever device they're on, could still join. Rather than everyone controlling the same character, I wanted to give everyone their own. You've all seen the title. Discord is the perfect app for that. You can make bots that are programmed to do all kinds of things, including playing games with you. With Discord, I can get the best of both worlds. Everyone can join as long as you're on the server, and everyone gets to play from their own perspective. So, how do you make a game in Discord? For that, you need a program that can send requests over the internet to the central Discord server. This can be done with an application programming interface, or API for short. There are Discord APIs available in just about any language you can imagine. So, I just close my eyes and... oh, Python it is. I got started with a simple bot to get to know the ropes, and after a couple of minutes, I already made an epic game. Ping pong! Whenever you say ping, the bot responds with pong, and then, wait for it, you say ping back, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong. Okay, I've got to come clear. That's not actually a game, it's just a connection test. But hey, now we know, it works at least. I wanted to do a little bit more than just ping ponging. I wanted to involve everyone. So, I thought it would be fun to make some sort of gambling game with a real Wheel of Fortune. But you know, gambling and kids don't really mix it well. But I really like the real world connection thingy, so I changed my plan a bit to something where people could change all kinds of things in my room. I set up an Arduino connection, just like how I've been doing with all my other projects, but now in Python. And with the right commands, users could do all kinds of stuff, well, at least change the color of my LEDs for now. That's something, alright. But, you know, this isn't really a game. This is just a light show. It was a fun proof of concept, but I wanted to involve a lot of people and still keep it personal. I had to go a different route. Sometimes you've got to kill your darlings. Back to the drawing board. I really wanted to make a game where each player could play their own character and battle or race against each other or something. For that, two things are really important: getting good player input and getting a clear output to make sure everybody knows what's happening. I looked back into the API and saw it was really easy to get player input in different ways. Players could send messages or add reactions, and the bot could then get a bunch of data, like who sent the message or reaction and where it was posted and even when. The biggest hurdle lies in the output. Since bots are also Discord users, they are kind of limited to what they can show. You could send a bunch of text, emojis, or in the extreme cases an image or even a web link. But I needed way more than an image. Or should I say, I needed way more images that come after each other. I needed a moving picture, or video as the kids call it these days. Too bad you can't render 3D images with a Discord bot, because I really wanted to make a 3D. Or can you? You've probably seen this coming from a mile away, but why don't I use the incredible Unity game engine as the host for my bot? Let's go! You're probably wondering why anyone in their right mind would do this and how this would work. Well, instead of letting everyone download the game, that would totally defeat the purpose of this little adventure, I just host a single instance of the game on my computer. Get the reactions and messages from the Discord server through the web and display the outcome of the game on my screen. Then I just have to share my screen in a live stream so everyone can watch it. It's kind of like Google Stadia or Xbox One, xCloud 360 first, or you know what I mean. Also known as gaming in the clouds. But now it's just like way slower. When I saw that Discord already had Unity integration for games, I thought I was good to go. Until I read what it actually does. It just shows your friends what you're playing. I needed a much deeper connection to send web requests to the Discord server and back. So Unity uses the C# scripting language, and like I mentioned before, Discord has API wrappers in just about any language. The C-sharp ones are called Discord.net and D-sharp plus. There is just one problem though. Although Unity uses C-sharp, it doesn't actually use the .NET standard. It uses Mono, a multi-platform, open-source implementation of .NET. I have no idea what this all means, but basically, it has the advantages of being multi-platform, but not everything from .NET actually works. So those magnificent frameworks aren't actually supported in Unity. Yeah, finding a framework that did work was quite a search. I even went to the obscure second page of Google. I mean, it makes sense. Who in their right mind would use a game engine to host a bot? If you were to sell that game, you would have millions of simultaneous hosts for the bot, all sending a bunch of messages as the same bot. Was this another stupid idea of mine? Did I not think this through? Should I just go back to the drawing board again? Or should I just quit? No, I wasn't giving up. If there is one thing I learned since the beginning of the internet, it's that you're never the only one who has a problem. And there is always someone from the other side of the world that has something useful. Luckily, I was able to find one. Discord Unity. Well, the name says it all. When I'm looking for obscure repos and I find what I'm looking for, I feel like Indiana Jones when he finds treasure, including the giant trap at the end, because there's always a tiny problem that needs fixing. In this case, the trap was that it hadn't been updated for over 2 years and they stopped developing it before it was fully finished. Something about that it shouldn't be used and you should use the Unity integration instead, but I knew that already. That ship has sailed a long time ago. This was the perfect thing to get going. There were only a couple of features missing, but since my last video when I improved a remote to Unity repository, I am now a master of adding to obscure Unity open source projects from years ago. So I got to work and floundered my way through the existing code, trying to keep it somewhat consistent, not without the occasional mental breakdown of course. I added the missing features that I still needed, and with the connection working again, I thought of a first prototype. The easiest way to control a character with Discord is with predetermined reactions. That means you just pick a reaction and the game does the rest. You can't really do fast-paced games like a racing game or a shooter, because getting a reaction over the internet takes a while. So I thought about a turn-based strategy game with little robots. Let me explain! Okay, so you're playing with this little robot, right? And there are all these other robots on the field. And of course, you want to completely destroy them. And what better way to do that than with a giant fist? Kaboom! Yeah, of course, you have to move as well. And in this game, it's all about timing. Each movement takes exactly 1 second. 1/4 turn, moving 1 tile forward. Or 1 attack, haha. Each player gets 2 actions per round, so you have to strategize to plan where you want to be to hit. Will you be able to dodge in time or be completely surrounded by your enemies? There is only one way to find out. To manage all of this, I added a bunch of programming. The first thing I added was some sort of movement system to easily control multiple bots with simple commands. If I tell the bot to move up, it'll go up 1 tile. And if it's not correctly rotated, it will do that first. Now I can control a whole bunch of robots with a couple of commands. Perfect for my secret robot army. Of course, I'm not the one who's going to be controlling this. You guys are. I set up one central controller to manage the connection with Discord. It could send messages and reactions and get notified when those come in as well. That controller then sends the data to everything on the playing field. You can't actually control a robot if the bot doesn't know which one belongs to you. And right now, they all look the same. And that's a little boring. To enter the game, I set it up so you need to react to the starting message with one of the predetermined colored emojis. That way, I can kill 2 birds in 1 stone. I know who's playing and what color they would like to be. To manage all the different actions a player can do, I made a custom action class that has all the necessary information, including what kind of emoji you need to react with. I made a list that contains all the different options, and when the game starts, the bot adds the reactions for all the possible actions to the message. All the options are pretty straightforward. There are a bunch of arrows pointing in all 4 directions to move, and a big cross to make a hit. Each player gets 2 actions, and can move or hit at either action. The way I achieved this is by sending 2 action messages each round, where the bot reacts with all the specified actions from the list from before. To keep a little pace in the game, I added the timer for each round. I did this by continuously updating the action message with the amount of time that's left. And once the timer hits 0, the next round automatically starts. This makes sure I don't have to manually end each round. And a little timer keeps things interesting. The bot also sends a pinned message that contains the current scoreboard and keeps track of who's still alive as well. Because it's pinned, you can always keep an eye on it to pick your next target. Each player has 2 lives and each hit deals 1 point of damage. For each hit you make, you get 1 point, and you get an extra point if you land a finishing blow. To make the game more appealing, I added the little robot and some animations to make him come to life. And with all of that, it was time for the first test run. Alright everyone, if you're ready, just hit the reaction and join the game. Ooh, a lot of people are joining already. It's gonna be a fun battle. Let's go! Oh man, I already took a hit. This is gonna be a short battle. Look at all the robots just moving. All that with just a simple reaction. What a wonderful world. They're still getting the hang of it seems, but they're doing great. Yes, I'm not the first one who's dead. Oh, they are just killing each other. This is wonderful. There I go. Well, let's just skip ahead. Okay, looks like it's a one-on-one battle. There's a lot of pokering going on. Who will make the first move? And who will be the loser? Yeah, just go there. Yes, yes. Oh my god. Just finish it already. I want to play more. Yes, the first successful battle. There's still a lot of work to do, so let's get to it. It was already a lot of fun, but there were some nasty bugs to squash. So I knew what I had to do before I could show it to the world. After I solved the bugs, I added some more cool features, like power-ups that can give you double speed, damage, and distance. I also added some obstacles like dangerous spikes and conveyor belts that take you along for a ride. To fit everyone on the screen, I made the grid infinitely expandable. I started with a very small grid where the first players are added, and once a certain amount of tiles are filled, the game board expands and adds new rows and columns. There really is no limit to how many people can join. The only limit is the screen resolution to make sure you can still see your robot on the screen. So after all of that, it was finally time to play with you guys. We gathered at my Discord server and had loads of fun. Alright, time to show these guys what I'm made of. Oh my god, I'm already dead. Well, let's try again. Yes, just one. Oh. Nope, dead. You know what they say? Third time. Dead again. Oh my god, why can't I just win once in my own game? I have to win someday, right? This time is gonna be the one, I feel it. I mean, it's a one-on-one. How can I lose? Yes, yes. The field is shrinking. Oh my god, I just need to hit first. I need to hit the first. Yes! After 3 days of continuous playing, I finally beaten my own game. If you're watching this video, chances are we're playing right now. So check out my Discord to come and play with us. See you there, but only after you've liked and subscribed. Because more people see this video, the more people can join in on the fun. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!